Wolf's Sunday Night Hall of Fame.
On AM 790, WAEB.
By 1962, the demands of songwriting, rehearsing, recording, and especially touring for 50 weeks out of every year was taking its toll, and the Skyliners were breaking up.
Joe Verschuren had left the group. We just got married, and Janet was tired of the traveling. You know, it was I guess it was around 1962 or something like that. She got tired of the travel, and she said, "I can't take it anymore. I'm going to quit." And Joe Verschuren just got married, and he said, "Well, she quits. You know, I'm gonna go too." And they'd been asking me to do some single things, you know, some solo things on Colpix. So I thought, you know, what's the sense of me trying to find another Janet and, you know, putting the group back together? And I just figured I'd go on my own, see what happened.
We're starting out now. I hope the road of love is long. But darling, if I stumble, and if I ever treat you wrong, no, never say goodbye. Cause darling, it would be a lonely life for me without your love. If I should ever hurt you, if I should ever make you cry, oh darling, please forgive me. Give our love another try. Come, darling, it would be a lonely life for me without your love, yeah.
Three records down the road, Janet got the bug again, and she got back into another group of Skyliners. It was Wally, Jack Taylor was still with them, and they got a guy named Sammy Morrow and Jack Gardner to sing lead on one song. It was called "Everyone But You." I wasn't supposed to be singing these songs, but that was the period of time when "Comes Love" was out.
my head. Don't know why I even bothered to try.
Skyliners and the Viscount label with Comes Love and Tell Me. Before that, one of the songs Jimmy Beaumont recorded as a solo artist, Never Say Goodbye. It was released in 1962 on the May record label. May was distributed by Colpix, and Jimmy's session was produced by Stu Phillips. It was Phillips who also arranged and produced another Colpix act from Pittsburgh, the Marcells. By 1970, the Skyliners had long since reunited with Jimmy Beaumont and were appearing back home in Pittsburgh and on occasional oldie shows produced at Madison Square Garden by Richard Nader. Then in 1974, the group was signed to a major record label as a single was released on Capitol with high expectations. On one side of the 45 was a song called Where Have They Gone, and the flip side was the group's version of a 1961 Ray Peterson hit, I Could Have Loved You So Well. It looked like history was about to repeat itself again, as the record was an instant smash back home in Pittsburgh. But this time, it would go no further.
Where Have They Gone was the hit. I mean, it was supposed to have been the hit side. But it got lost in the shuffle with Capitol. At that time, they had, I think there was a McCartney thing coming out, George Harrison. It was the number one record in Pittsburgh for 3 or 4 weeks.
Where have they gone? The summers we knew, when we all the same, and the gentle wave or two. Where have they gone? All the winters we shared. My head. Thank you.
can never be true.
Of the Skyliners has truly stood the test of time, and Jimmy Beaumont has long been recognized as one of the finest lead singers of all time. It's all the more amazing when you stop to realize that Jimmy had just turned 18 years old when he recorded some of the greatest love songs in rock and roll history. If you require proof that their music is indeed timeless, consider that no less than four of their songs, Believe Me, How Much, This I Swear, and Since I Don't Have You were featured in the soundtrack of a contemporary hit movie like Lethal Weapon 2. The Skyliners have been one of my personal favorites since the first time I heard their incredible harmonies in the radio back in late 1958. We all have our favorite Skyliner songs, and Jimmy Beaumont is no different.
Believe me, I kind of like that. Since I Don't Have You would have to be there, and How Much. That's one of my favorite songs, How Much. I thought it was well-written, and the arrangement was, you know, Lenny Martin's arrangements were always right on the money. He just knew right where we were, you know. It was a good combination, arranger and artist song.
Go, you must not, knowing time.
I hope you've enjoyed our tribute to one of the greatest doo-wop groups of the early rock years. Thank you for spending one night with the Skyliners.
One night is all I need.
This is Jimmy Beaumont of the Skyliners. You're listening to Rod Wolf in the original Sunday Night Hall of Fame on AM 790 WAEB.